single parents. It's tough to do. It's tough to successfully pull off.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? And if you want to look at the demographics, Bay, what do you think the demographic for most single moms in this country is?
Like, what you mean?
What demographic? What race do you think they are?
I think it's a mixture.
Yeah, go on.
It's a mixture of the people, because my saying is, like I tell people, you don't want to have kids, protect yourself.
Mm-hmm. Get on birth control.
Yeah, Second Amendment.
Well, you know, wrap it up or get on birth control. Or don't have sex at all.
Uh-huh.
Because let this say, like I know quite a few times, I got tons of stories. But
excuse me.
Do you?
Not me. This is by people that I know. Now let this say you the people that go out to the clubs.
Uh-huh.
You know what I'm saying? And you like partying.
Yeah.
And you like having sex. And you know the dude or the girl that you met, you ain't gonna see them again. And then next thing you know, mess around and have a baby. And then be like, oh, I don't want this baby. Get an abortion. Other person, no, I'm gonna keep it.
Yeah.
And that's where the problem starts right there.
Mm.
A lot of people do that. That's why I say, why are you going around having babies and you're not trying to take care of them?
I'm sorry.
Because I was playing
a game.
I know some people that got 20 kids, 9 kids, 15 kids, ain't taking care of none of them.
Man.
It's crazy how that works.
You know, and here's the thing. I don't mind when, you know, these, okay, let me take a step back. I don't want kids being aborted. Okay? You know what I mean?
But that's my thing. If you don't want to have kids, you got to protect yourself.
Agreed.
From having kids.
Agreed. But, man, there's more incentive from the government. You have a kid, you're single.
Oh, you getting the WIC, you getting sex and eight.
Uh-huh.
You getting food stamps.
It is nothing but encouraging to continue to have kids.
Mm-hmm.
When you're on the government dole, because you will increase money coming in.
Mm-hmm. And at the end of the year, you get your taxes.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And a lot of people do that.
And it's a tough balance because you people need to step up.
Yeah.
Take responsibility for themselves more.
Mm-hmm.
Don't get me wrong. If you're able to get help.
Yes.
But that help has got to stop eventually. And I'm realizing this myself. Like, and I do not want to go on the VA. Okay? I don't want to have to rely on a government check. But another thing, too, at the same time, what I'm in a civil war with my head is that VA would have helped me out immensely during shutdown and COVID when all my gigs and my events and my parties got canceled.
Mm-hmm.
So now I'm in an even bigger debate. And my battle buddies, you deserve it, Joe. You deserve that, getting the VA assistance every month. Damn it, I don't want to rely on it. But damn it, it would help out.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I know exactly what you're saying.
Everybody's making tough decisions right now, man. You can't beat yourself up over it.
You don't want to get dependent on it.
No.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Hell no. And I've seen so many of my battle buddies put in these fake claims, if you will, to get so much from the VA every month.
Mm-hmm.
And they're disabled veterans. Hey, Joe, you want to go work out? What? You want to go to the gym?
No.
What? Aren't you getting like 100% from the VA because you have a back that is never going to work ever again? Do you know
tough.
What I mean?
Yeah. But the thing, too, is you got
to
remember,
like,
you didn't do anything to lose your work. That's not a decision that you made. It's like the government decided. And whether or not they're right about it, that's irrelevant to this discussion. It's like, They drove a truck through your opportunity to make money. They destroyed your front door.
Uh-huh.
Blew up your house of making money.
Uh-huh.
It's not on you to fix that. It's on them to fix that.
Okay.
And so you can't take responsibility for all these things that you are out of your control. And if there are ways that you can, I don't know. That's just my opinion. You know, where in my house, you know, we did make some difficult decisions on how to make money that we didn't rely on any extra incentives like that. But
yeah,
it's just up to you, man, and nobody can judge you for it, I think.
Agreed. It's myself judging myself.
Yeah. Just don't be so hard on yourself. There's a lot going on right now.
I'm going to be softer on myself.
No, I
hear you.
We all need to tell each other that.
I hear you. Yeah. It's the fear of being hypocritical is...
Yeah.
Right, is... Because I'm trying to be a better man. I am. And like Eddie Vedder once said, can't find a better man. Can't find a better man.
Wouldn't it be a great story, though, as someone like you to go on it and then succeed and then come back off of it and show that you can transition back out of something like that? I think that's a story that should be told.
I'll tell you
honestly.
What. If I get compensated for some knee issues that I currently have that were definitely during Army times... you know what? I'll tell you what. Next Friday, coming on the show, is the area's head of Veterans Affairs.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's great.
This that's great. Will be a one-on-one style of conversation with him. And I look forward to his answers.
Excellent. I'm going to check it out.
And that's called an organic campaign right there.
That's right.
Shame.
Promotion. Organic campaign.
Yep.
You know what they say in class, right? If the teacher says it twice, you got to write it down.